Good afternoon. Welcome to the St. Cecilia School Christmas program. It's always a very special day for us to celebrate with our parents and family members and friends the wonderful gifts and talents that our children have. Before we begin our program, we're going to take a moment and center ourselves and pray. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the many blessings that you have bestowed upon us, and we especially thank you for the gift of this day where we can come together and sing and celebrate as we remember the birth of your Son, Jesus. Bless our songs, our dance, all of our talents, and let them be a sign of our great love for you. We ask this in the name of Jesus. Amen. In the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce the Christmas lights.
Don't I know peace, no peace, passion. Yes. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and the house twinkled with lights.
With each the glowing spirit as the season shined bright.
A wise grandpa and his grandkids three
arrived home with smiles of glee.
A question soon arose from the eldest child.
A curiosity that made her elder smile.
Grandpa, why do you put up so many Christmas lights?
Yeah, Grandpa. And why do you always put up more and more every year?
Oh. I have my reasons. But we would need to read a Christmas story in order for you to completely understand.
The one about the Grinch?
No, not that one.
Frosty?
Polar Express?
No, no. One I don't think you've heard before. Come inside. I'll read it with you. So this story has a little bit of everything. Mystery. Ooh. Intrigue. Ooh. Love. Yeah. Okay. And adventure. Let's see. Can you grab me that notebook over there?
This old thing, it looks like a notebook. I thought you said you were reading us a Christmas story.
I am. It's in here. But we'll get to it soon enough. First, we start with the story of the three lights. Michael and Gabriel anxiously awaited the arrival of their helpers.
So, where are they?
They should be here any moment.
Are they dependable?
Of course.
Reliable.
Isn't that the same thing? Yeah, mm-hmm.
Do they understand the importance?
Absolutely. Oh, and here they are.
Right here.
Oh, hey, didn't recognize you. Yo, what's with the getup?
Messenger?
Protector?
It's for the future. Michael, their task?
We have an important task for you three.
Yes, sir!
We need your help to bring the light out of others.
Did you bring the supplies we asked for?
Did you bring the guiding lights?
Oh!
Yes, of course. A candle.
And for my job, a star. Not just any star, an extra bright star.
And a light bulb!
Do you think that's a good idea?
I thought you said reliable.
I did. There must be an explanation.
Putting up the Christmas tree, the winter come around.
The story began with a visit from above.
To a humble woman, a servant of love.
In the town of Nazareth in Galilee.
The angels appeared to a woman named Mary.
So, the Christmas story begins with a special visitor to an even more special woman.
Mother Mary?
The very one. She was given a special gift, which took incredible strength to accept.
Mary, do not be afraid. No, that doesn't work. Too much.
Mary, Mary, do not be afraid.
No, that doesn't work. Too little. Yo, yo, Mary, what's up? No, I don't even know. Oh, hey.
Who are you talking to?
I was just practicing. Wait, what are you wearing?
You know, disguises. A candle,
light bulb.
And I'm a star.
What?
Taylor Swift.
We said for the future. For the future! You know what? It'll have to work for now. But from now on, I expect you to be in uniform. Anyway, I'm delivering a message of joy and peace to somebody special.
Who?
Mary.
With the little lamb?
No, but kind of, weirdly enough, yes.
Who is she?
She's going to be the mother of God.
Of God?
Yeah, you know, the big guy, the boss, the great I am.
Yeah, I know who he is, but you said mother.
Indeed, and you are coming with me.
God sent the angel Gabriel to a virgin who lived in Nazareth, a town in Galilee. She was engaged to marry a man named Joseph from the family of David. Her name was Mary. Here, read with me.
The angel came to her and said, "Hail Mary, the Lord is with you."
But Mary was very confused by what the angel said. Mary wondered, "What does this mean?"
The angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary, because God is pleased with you.
You will give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great, and will be called the Holy Son of God."
How can this happen?
God's power will come over you, and the Holy Spirit will come down to you. So your child will be called the Holy Son of God. Nothing is impossible for God.
I am the Lord's servant. Be it done unto me according to your word.
Like a single candle used to light the many, may this light spread from you to all you will inspire. And now to Joseph.
Mary's husband. Are you ready?
Yeah, I got this.
Thank you. to grow up when it seems the magic slipped away. We find it all again on Christmas Day.
Believe in what your heart is saying. Hear the melody that's playing. There's no time to waste. There's so much to celebrate. Believe in what you feel inside. Give your dreams a wings.
The story he told with wisdom and insight
reminded his grands of the events of that night.
A father-to-be, strong but scared,
tried to make his head and heart prepared.
Confused by the news, a decision to make.
Joseph was visited before he was to wake.
So, Gabriel was sent to help Joseph.
The one with the beautiful coat?
No, the one
that takes her Jesus to Mary?
Her husband?
The very same. You see, he was confused by the whole thing and, well, listened and here.
So, who are we going to talk to next?
Joseph.
The dreamer.
Yes.
Son of Jacob.
Yeah, no. A different Joseph. A carpenter. A good man.
All right, I think I'm ready.
Are you coming too?
Yeah, I want to see how this plays out. How are you going to talk to him?
I'm not sure. It must be subtle. Gentle.
Wait. I have an idea. What if we do it in a dream? This is coming in handy.
You're such a...
Please, stop.
How can this be? I cannot believe it. I do not know what I should do. I cannot possibly stay, but what harm could come to her if I leave her? What harm could come if I accuse her? I need to go, for her sake and for my own. I will leave quietly, so that no harm will come to her.
As Joseph lay his head down to dream, the angels came down to visit.
Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child who has been conceived within her is of the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Joseph, the candlelight. Even the darkest of dark can be driven out by a single flame. Let this light guide you and your family to where you need to be. And let it serve as a reminder to drive out the fear, nervousness, and doubt from within. For the Lord needs you. We need you. Your family needs you.
Do you think it will work?
We shall see. The choice is still ultimately his to make. I believe the candlelight was a good choice.
Even the darkest of dark can be driven away by a single flame.
And let this light remind you. That was amazing. Who knew you had it in you?
I know what I must do, Lord. Help me to be a builder of unity. Help me to be an instrument of reconciliation.
And see, today, we drive out the darkness and prepare the way when we light the candles of the Advent wreath. The candle brought Mary and Joseph together in preparation for their journey as a family.
So, Gabe the babe, is it time for me to start yet?
No.
There is a candle in every soul, some brightly burning, some dark and cold.
There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites a candle, and makes his home.
Carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the helpless, confused and torn, and hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle, go light your world. Take your candle, go light your world. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take
go light your world.
To stay close.
God's light to
The children listened intently to the words,
remembering the story of the Savior's birth.
Time has passed, with Joseph always by Mary's side.
Supporting, guiding, loving, taking everything in stride.
The big day, the promised gift.
A present of love to give our world a needed lift.
No, the story doesn't end there. You see, it was only the beginning.
Of course, Joseph and Mary traveled many miles.
To a little town.
Called Bethlehem.
When they got to the town, there was no room left.
I'm sorry, I do not have any room, but I see your need. And well, I have a small manger just upon the hill. It's not much, but it should keep you warm and dry and serve as a shelter.
Now, do you know what happens next?
The angels appear to the shepherds.
Do not be afraid.
Yes, yes, and the wise men soon after. But the King of Kings, God's great gift, was going to be born in a manger. How would they know where to find him?
The star, the second light.
So the words say, nearby shepherds were living in a field, guarding their sheep at night. The Lord's angel stood before them. The Lord's glory shone around them, and they were terrified.
Don't be afraid. Look, I bring good news to you. Wonderful, joyous news for all people. Your Savior is born today in David's city. He is Christ the Lord. This star is a sign for you. You will find a newborn baby wrapped snugly and lying in a manger.
Suddenly, a great assembly of the heavenly forces was with the angel praising God. They said,
Glory to God in heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors.
Let us go to Bethlehem and see what's happened.
Let us confirm what the Lord has revealed to us.
What about the wise guys?
Wise men.
Same thing.
Actually, Wise Guys is a great Italian restaurant up the road a bit. It also references.
Oh, middle child, the wise men. Can I continue? Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, the wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying,
"Where is he who has been born king of the Jews?
For we saw a star when it rose, and have come to worship him."
And I chose a star, because in a sky of a million lights, one that shines brightest will be high and mighty, to show the way. The star has staying power, and looks from above to guide and lead us. The star leads the way.
And behold, the star that they had seen when it rose before them until it came to rest over the place where the child was.
When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. And going into the house, they saw the child with his mother, Mary. They fell down and worshipped him.
Opening the treasures, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
And being warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed to their own country by another way.
And now look upon the tree, in every house, everywhere.
We put a star on top of the tree.
Above the presents.
To remind us.
Yes?
Well, we understand what you're trying to teach us and all.
And we appreciate the lesson.
But, well, you still haven't told us why there's so many Christmas lights. And I may not be a Bible scholar, but I'm pretty sure it's not in there.
And it looks like we've come to the end of the three lights.
Never think that third angel, the one with the light bulb.
Oh. Yeah, I feel like she would have an idea about this.
My wise, wise grandchildren, you are all correct. You will not find the answer in the Bible, although I did. And we did come to the end of our story because the last one. Let's just say I've always known it by heart and never had the chance to write it down. Too busy putting up more Christmas lights. And for that, we go back to the beginning. I might have left a little out of the story.
Did you bring the guiding lights?
Oh!
Yes, of course. A candle.
And for my job, a star. Not just any star, an extra bright star.
And a light bulb.
Do you think that's a good idea?
I thought you said reliable.
I did. There must be an explanation.
I chose the candle because of its power and its simplicity. A single flame drives out the darkness and can be used to light the flame of countless others. The candle will live on as a symbol of light, preparation, unity, marriage, and even birthdays. The candle prepares the way.
And I chose a star because in a sky of a million lights, one that shines brighter will be high and mighty to show the way. The star has staying power and looks from above to guide and lead us. The star hangs in the heavens for all to look up to. The star leads the way.
I know. This may be different and not as poetic as you guys, but I'm here for the future because there's going to be a time and a place where many may not forget this moment but lose sight of its meaning. And we need to be reminded of love, reminded to pray, because this light is there for those helpers later down the road. This light will serve as a reminder.
So, you ask me why I hang so many lights each and every year. Well, it's because they represent my prayers for so many. I hang a strand for them, the reason we have light. Your grandma taught me this many years ago.
Is this a tradition we're going to be doing every year?
I love Christmas time and the lights. The lights are the best part.
Yeah. But you ever wonder why we do it? I mean, it's not like we're lighting the candles to the Advent wreath.
I know, but for me, it's important. I like to think that they represent prayers.
Prayers?
Yeah, each little light represents my petitions, a little light of hope.
Actually, that's kind of cool.
I know it might sound silly, but as we walk around and look, it gives me hope.
Instead of lights, you see prayers. I get it now.
Lighting the way, here, these. These are for us, our life, our friends, and our family-to-be.
The first strand is always for you guys, and your parents, and your uncles, and aunts. The first strand's always for family. Your grandma taught me, though, to think outside of ourselves, to be thankful for those who help us along the way.
So, who are we adding a strand for this year?
For those that help us.
For those that keep us healthy.
For those that help us heal when we are not.
For those that heal and lead us spiritually.
For those that protect us and keep us safe.
For those here and abroad.
There are so many, and each light of the strand lit as a prayer. So, it's not that I want more lights, it's that I have more prayers.
They're hanging all the lights on the main street square. People are smiling everywhere. Trees up in the windows, frost on the glass. Christmas is here now, here at last.
Just want to say congratulations to our eighth grade class, our cast for this year's Christmas pageant. You did an excellent job. Thank you, class of 2018. And thanks to Mr. Bagtis, our pianist. Mrs. Barris and Mrs. Hoskin, who worked behind the scenes to get all our costumes ready, make sure everybody had their parts together. Congratulations to them. To McNally Enterprises for our lighting and sound. You just make our pageant so much more spectacular, so thank you very much for your contribution. And last but not least, to our fantastic music director, Mrs. Christine Linares. Okay, this concludes our program, boys and girls. We're going to let the grown-ups leave church first. So if you would just stay seated and wait till your teachers give you directions, that would be really helpful. And if you're a grown-up, this is your opportunity to get out fast. Thank you very much.
check 2 1 2 2 2 2 check 2 1 2 2 2 2 check 2 1 2 2 2 check 2 1 2. You got it muted. Nope, you don't. 2 2 2 1 2. Check 2 1 2 2 2 2 2. Check 2 1 2 2. 2 2.
Wait 1 second until they leave, and then I'll have you walk.
They're going to Divas, the bikini bar. And check 2 2 2. Hey, check 2 2 1 2 2 2. Check 2 2. Check 2 2. Yeah, hey. And it came to pass that Mr. Marshall said, "Do not confuse my love for hockey with a desire to go to Canada." Hey, hey, check 2. And behold, the Sacramento Kings said, "We are not the LA Kings. Do not confuse basketball with hockey." Ha ha. Two. Wah, bah, bah. It's like about 800. Got a wah. Got a honkiness. Check. 2 2 1 2. Yeah, hey. Check 2. 2 2 2 2. Woo ha. 2 2 ha. Hey, 2 1 2. Yeah, hey, check, check, wah, 2 wah, 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 wah. Hey, 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 2 1 2. Yeah, hey, check. And lo, they said, lower and lower. Now, can you get any more volume than that?
Oh, yeah.
Out of it? Two. Yeah, hey. 2 2 1 2. Yeah, hey. Yeah, that's what it was lacking. It was a little bit of, just a little bit of low end in it. Yeah. Something down around 200 or 300. And two. And just a little bit of, to give it a little bit of definition behind the words. And then that sounded like a little bit of feedback around 300 or 400.
Yeah,
two. Yeah, hey, two, two, check, two. One. And two, one, two. Check, two. Speak not ill of hockey. Speak not ill of hockey, for Mr. Marshall will not condone your behavior. Yeah. Chicago, let's all go to Portillo's and have Italian beef. Two, 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 two. Brad? Two, two, two. Check two, one, two. Check two, 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 two. And hey, two, 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 two.